I have around 16 years of teaching experience in different engineering colleges of India. Right now, I am pursuing PhD since 2011. I have done M.Tech in VLSI design in 2009, as well as BE in electronics and telecommunication in 1998. These are the subjects in which I got sufficient knowledge from my gurus so that I can share my expertise on the following subjects: signals and systems, digital signal processing using MATLAB, CMOS digital integrated circuits analysis and design, electronic design automation, that is EDA, circuit analysis and synthesis. Let's take signal and system. The course objectives are understanding real meaning of processing of signals through system. In this course, we will learn how the signals are altered through the systems and why we are doing this and how to do this. The conceptualization of LTI system, that is called linear time invariant systems. In this, we will learn how to take the convolutions, how to make the system useful, and what are the different properties of linear time invariant system. At the last, we will see the MATLAB, that is the matrix laboratory, which is a software in which we see some commands through which signal processing can be delivered. These are the contents of signal and systems. First, concepts and properties of signal and system. In this, we will see the basic concepts like what is signals, what are systems, what are the different types of signals and systems, also what are the different properties of the systems. Second, LTI systems, that is the linear time invariant system. This is the basic and ideal systems through which we can understand the more complex systems like non-linear and time-varying systems. These non-linear and time-varying systems are generally available in our daily life. Third, Laplace and Judge transform. These are basic tools by which we convert a time-domain quantity into a frequency-domain quantity and vice versa. These are useful in circuit theory. We use the Laplace transform in digital signal processing. We use that transform, and in many other subjects, we need Laplace and their transforms. Fourth, Fourier analysis and synthesis for continuous time and discrete time signal. Basically, in this, we will go through Fourier series for periodic signals and Fourier transform for non-periodic signals. Basically, Fourier analysis gives only frequency analysis, whereas Laplace and Z transform will give complete information regarding amplitude and frequency of the signal waveform. So Laplace transform and Z transform are more complete as compared to Fourier transforms and Fourier series. Fifth, time and frequency characterization of signal and systems. In this, we will understand magnitude and phase representation of the Fourier transform, as well as time and frequency characterization of different type of filters. 6. Sampling of continuous time signals. In this, we will cover sampling theorem, interpolation, that is how to reconstruct the signals from a sampled version. We will see the discrete time processing of the continuous time signals. And at the last, we will see the sampling of a discrete time signals and why we use the sampling of a discrete time signals. 7. Communication system. In this, we will understand the basic building blocks of the communication system. Also, we will go through modulation concepts and different type of modulation, that is the amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, and the phase modulation. 8. Linear feedback systems and control basics. After a brief introduction of linear feedback system, in this we will go through some application and consequences of feedback. Also, we will see root locus technique for linear feedback systems. By Nyquist stability criteria of the linear feedback system, we understand the stability criteria of a linear feedback system. Last, MATLAB. This is the acronym of matrix laboratory. In this, we will understand different commands used for convolution and different processing of the signals through the systems. These are the usefulness of the signal and systems. The course is designed basically for Indian undergraduate electronics, electrical, computer science, diploma holder and engineering students, and particularly for industrial persons working in some processing industry or organizations. The concepts and techniques that form the core of the subject are used in almost all engineering disciplines. This course brings a unification of a continuous time and discrete time signal analysis and synthesis, and this unification is vital in understanding the difficult concepts in different processing of industrial systems. Next subject is digital signal processing, that is DSP in short, using MATLAB. The course objectives are understanding fundamentals of digital signal processing, emphasis on digital filter structure and design, use of upsampling and downsampling, use of MATLAB for better understanding of the course. These are the contents of the DSP using MATLAB. In this, first is the introduction of DSP. In this, we will understand the basic concepts of digital signal processing, basic building blocks, why DSP is better than its counterpart, that is the analog signal processing, and many more basic fundamentals of DSP is covered. Second, discrete time signals and system in time and frequency domain. In this, basically, we will go through the discrete time Fourier transform and Z transforms. Third, LTA discrete time systems in frequency domain. In this, we will understand the transfer function and the frequency response. We will go through the stability test using the transfer function and frequency response basically. Fourth, the digital processing of continuous time signals. In this, we see how the sampling affects the signals in time and in frequency domain, both. Also, we will cover the analog to digital and digital to analog converters. Fifth, digital filter structures and design. In this, we will see how we realize the two basic digital filters, that is the finite impulse response, in short we call it FIR, and infinite impulse response, in short we call it IIR filter. These two digital filters are the basic building blocks of any digital signal processing. So we will go through in this the detailed realization of the digital filter using different type of structure, for example direct one, direct two, cascaded, series and all others. We will see also the design part, that is the implementation part of IIR and FIR filter design. 6. Analysis of finite word length effects. In this, we will see the quantization of the binary number system, the coefficient quantization effects, and the analysis of arithmetic round-off errors. 7. Multi-rate digital signal processing. In this, we see why the sampling rate alteration is required and how it is beneficial to do in discrete time rather than in continuous time. In this, we will understand what is decimator and interpolator, and we will design these, and also we will see what are the different filter banks and the design path of it. Last, projects. In this, we use basically the MATLAB for FIR filter design and implementation, modulator and demodulation, etc.
These are the usefulness of the course DSP using MATLAB. Basically, this course is designed for Indian undergraduate electronics, electrical, computer science, diploma and engineering students, and particularly for industrial persons working in some processing industry or organization. The concepts and techniques that form the core of the subject are used in digital processing of control appliances and other equipment. The course brings understanding of filters, which are basic building blocks in every industrial system. Next subject is CMOS digital integrated circuit, its analysis and design. CMOS basically stands for complementary metal oxide semiconductor. These are the course objective. Because of their intrinsic feature in low power consumption, large noise margin and ease of design, CMOS integrated circuits have been widely used to develop RAM chips, microprocessor chips, DSP chips, ASIC chips, portable computers, personal digital assistants, portable phones and multimedia agents, etc. To be able to do analysis and synthesis of small circuits and large VLSI circuits, we have to understand the CMOS digital fundamentals. To understand the layout and schematics of digital CMOS circuits, these are the course objectives. These are the contents of CMOS digital integrated circuit analysis and design subject. First is VLSI design methodology. In this, we will understand the basic fundamentals of VLSI, like Moore's law, VLSI design flow, etc. In this, we understand the different terms like regularity, modularity, and locality. We understand the design hierarchies. Full custom and semi-custom chip design is covered also. Second is the fabrication of MOSFETs. In this, different process flow and the different basic steps involved in NMOS and PMOS as well as CMOS annual process is covered. Layout design rules, full custom mask layout design rules are also covered. Third, MOS transistor modeling of MOS transistor using SPICE. In this topic, we covered MOS structure, MOSFET VI characteristics, scaling and its effects. Basic concepts of SPICE is covered. Level 1, 2 and 3 model equation is understood. Different SPICE MOSFET models is also covered. Fourth is MOS inverters, static switching characteristic as well as the interconnect effects. In this, we go through different type of NMOS inverter like resistor load inverter, enhancement load inverter, depletion load inverter, as well as we will see the how CMOS inverter is better than the NMOS inverter. We go through its static and switching characteristic as well as the delay calculation of the CMOS inverter is covered. Estimation of interconnect parasitic, calculation of interconnect delay is also covered in this topic. Switching power dissipation of CMOS inverter is also covered. Fifth, combinational and sequential MOS logic circuits. In this, we understand how different Boolean expression can be implemented using CMOS circuits. The fundamental of CMOS transmission gate, which is usually called pass gate, is also covered. In sequential circuits, latch and flip-flop is detailed covered. Next topic is dynamic logic circuit. In this, pass transistor basic principles, synchronous dynamic circuit techniques are also covered. Seventh is semiconductor memories. We will see the random only memory, static random access memory, and dynamic random access memory, how the internal circuits are built using CMOS fundamentals. Eighth is low power CMOS logic circuits. In this, we will understand how scaling affects the power dissipation as well as we see estimation and optimization of switching activities. Adiabatic logic circuit is also covered. Ninth is BiCMOS logic circuits. We see why we need BiCMOS logic circuits, what are the static behavior, what are the different static and switching delays in BiCMOS circuits. These are the usefulness of the CMOS digital integrated circuit analysis and design. Basically, this course is interdisciplinary graduate program for electronics, electrical, computer science diploma holder and engineers that helps shaping the future leaders of VLSI industry. The concepts and techniques that form the core of the subjects are used in fabrication of digital ICs. This course brings understanding of analysis and synthesis of inverter circuit and other complex VLSI circuits. Our next subject is Electronics Design Automation, that is in short called EDA. These are the course objective. Electronics Design Automation is a category of software tools for designing electronic systems such as PCBs and ICs. The tools work together in a design flow that chip designer use to design and analyze entire semiconductor chips. These are the contents of EDA. We will cover first concepts of EDA, design cycles, Moore's law, other basic concepts of CMOS VLSI, introduction of Tanner EDA software tool. Schematic editor is one of the tools which we cover in detail. In this, we understand how the schematic is developed, how we use the symbols of different schematic to be used in the complex circuits. Next is the layout editor, in which we draw the layout of different circuits, and we will see also how the complex layout we can design. We also go through the stick diagram, which is helpful to design the layout. T-Spice will give us the netlist, and in this we use some commands which will give us the output that is in the waveform form on the waveform editor tool. Waveform editor tool will give us the different calculation of the delays as well as the rise time and the fall time also. Layout versus schematic editor is a tool in which the output files of layout and schematic is compared, and it has been seen that which file is giving better results. Last is the projects. In this we will see different type of projects, like for example the multiplier layout, the adder layout, and different other projects we will see. These are the usefulness of EDA. The course is designed for an Indian undergraduate student and particularly for industrial persons in some VLSI industry or organization. Useful for electronics, electrical, computer science, and diploma engineers. The course brings a practical hands-on practice of CMOS VLSI schematic and layout design. Our last subject is circuit analysis and synthesis. These are the course objectives: understanding the basics of the circuits and developing concepts of analysis and synthesis of different circuits. These are the contents of circuit analysis and synthesis. First, review of signal and system, network theorems and elements, transient analysis, second order circuits, magnetically coupled circuits, two port networks, parameters and their interconnections, network functions, elements of realizability theory, positive real functions, testing of positive real functions, LC, RC and RL driving point function and synthesis, elementary RLC one port synthesis. These are the usefulness of circuit analysis and synthesis course. This course is designed for Indian undergraduate electronics, electrical, computer science, diploma and engineering students. The concepts and techniques that form the core of the subject are useful in almost all engineering disciplines. The course gave confidence in handling different circuits in industry.